Let me welcome you to this unique course titled Concepts of Thermodynamics or Concepts in Thermodynamics. Now, thermodynamics is a highly conceptual subject, and I can tell you that most of the students and even teachers find it difficult to synthesize the essential components of the conceptual paradigms in thermodynamics. So, why should we learn all these concepts? We should learn all these concepts because in engineering applications and in other applications also, which I will remark, thermodynamics is almost everywhere. Let us take the example of a power plant, a thermal power plant. A thermal power plant runs by following the basic principles and laws of thermodynamics. How does an automobile run? How does a combustion process take place? How does a manufacturing process work? All these questions can be answered with the aid of the basic laws of thermodynamics. Not only the engineered systems, think about a biological system. So, those who are in the biological world may think that thermodynamics is a subject which is very much different from the area in which they are working, but it is not. The entire philosophy of evolution of life is governed by the laws of thermodynamics. So, when we start our life with birth, the probability of birth is the least amongst all the events which take place in life. So, that means the entropy is very low and the free energy is very high. Then from birth to death, as we move along, the free energy of the living system decreases, and death is the condition under which the free energy becomes a minimum. So, this example I am giving just to illustrate that starting from an engineering to a biological system, thermodynamics is inevitable. In this particular course, we will have a unified view of the understanding of thermodynamics, and we will mainly touch upon concepts rather than formula. And through these conceptual paradigms, we will discuss about the properties of pure substances, the concepts of heat and work, which were the fundamental premises of the historical development of the thermodynamics as a engineering subject. Then the first law, the second law, of course, the concept of entropy, concepts of exergy and irreversibility, that is how to think of what is the maximum possible work that can be exploited from a given energy conversion system, and then applications to practical thermodynamic cycles in terms of air standard cycles and vapor power cycles. So, this will be the broad curriculum that will be covered. This is the standard curriculum not only across India, but almost across all around the globe as a first course of thermodynamics for engineering students, and we will follow that universal first level undergraduate curriculum for developing this course. I hope that this course will be very enjoyable and interactive. We will try to work out a large number of problems through the regular class session and the tutorial session, and we will have a unique mixing of traditional way of solving the problem and computer based solution of problems. And in that respect, I will be joined by my colleague Professor Aditya Bandyopadhyay, who will be another co-instructor of this course. Thank you very much for listening to this introductory video. I hope to have fruitful interactions with you over the lectures to come. Thank you.